What's up, friends? As some of you might know, just over a month ago, Canon announced a free software that lets you use your Canon camera as a webcam for streaming and other purposes. This was something many people wished for, since you had to use third-party software or a pricey capture card to use your Canon camera as a webcam in the past. This is no longer the case, as you can now just use the Canon EOS webcam utility and connect your camera with USB to use it as a webcam. Now, if you're a Lumix shooter, here comes the best part. Panasonic has listened to their customers and created a pretty similar software for most Lumix users that is now available for free. These are the models that are currently supported. So now you might be asking yourself, do you still need a capture card, or is the software good enough as a replacement? Let's find out together in this video. Hi, my name is Valentin Kosenko and welcome to my channel. I'm a creative entrepreneur and here to share my experiences with you. If you're new here, consider subscribing to get notifications for new videos as soon as they come out. Currently, the Lumix Tether for streaming software is only available for Windows. We might see a Mac version in the future though. If you want to download the software, just go ahead and follow the link in the video description. You will need to enter your camera serial code to download the software, which is usually located at the bottom of your camera. After you've installed the software, all you have to do is connect your camera with the included USB cable and choose tether mode. I have also tried some other cables, but the footage seemed to be a little choppy, so I guess you have to use a higher quality cable if you want a longer option. As soon as you've started up the software, you'll be able to activate Live View to monitor your camera. You can change most settings from here, but the most important for streaming is this option, which disables all the user interface elements for a clean output. You can also choose the live view quality, which ranges from 640 to 1280 pixels in width. Capture cards offer a lot higher resolutions than that. And the one I'm personally using, which by the way is the AVR Media Live Gamer 4K, offers UHD resolution at up to 60 frames. The results you get with a capture card are a lot sharper, but to use it, you need a dedicated PCIe slot in your PC. There are USB options as well though. The problem with the Lumix Tether for streaming software is that it does not work with Skype or comparable other software straight out of the box, because you have to capture the window using additional other software like OBS and use the VirtualCam plugin to simulate a video output. Still, I am pretty certain that a direct show output is something that will be added in a later version of the software. Canon is doing it in the beta already, so I think Panasonic should be able to implement that feature as well, so that you don't have to rely on third-party plugins. I have a small workaround for you if you want to use your Lumix camera as a webcam in Skype, Zoom, Discord, or other platforms. To do that, first follow the link in the video description and install the free Open Broadcast Software, or OBS in short. Make sure to also install VirtualCam, which you can also download from a link in the video description. If you're only interested in streaming using OBS though, you don't need to install VirtualCam. Now, the first thing you have to do in OBS is create a new scene and add window capture as a source. Now choose the Lumix Tether Live View window and you should see what your camera is capturing. Since we are capturing the window, you might want to crop the gray bars away. Just press Alt on your keyboard and use your mouse to adjust the cropping. Scale to the right size and you should be good to go. Unlike a regular capture card, the Tether software does not support audio capture, so you still have to set that up in every single individual software. Let's start with OBS. Go ahead and add audio input capture to your scene. Now, choose a microphone and click on OK. If you're experiencing latency issues, go ahead and click on the cog icon on one of the audio inputs inside of the audio mixer and choose Advanced Audio Properties. Choose Mono for your microphone input. This will make sure that the mono signal of your voice recording will be played back on both the left and the right speaker. Adjust the sync offset until no latency is noticeable. You'll have to create a few recordings to test that. 150 milliseconds worked pretty well for my GH5, but depending on your camera, your mileage may vary. If you want to set up multiple audio inputs, make sure to adjust your track settings accordingly. So that's how you set everything up in OBS. To use this video output as a webcam in Discord, Skype, etc., we still have to enable our virtual cam. Click on Tools and then click on Virtual Cam. Then click on Start and you should be able to find your camera output in Discord. This only transfers the video stream though, so you still have to set up your audio input in every individual software. If you have audio latency issues, set the buffered frames to a lower number. Depending on your CPU usage, this might result in dropped frames though, so make sure to test that first. Now that we're done setting everything up, how does a capture card compare to the new Lumix Tether for streaming software? Just as I've said, the resolution options in the software are limited, and a capture card will usually offer an image that is a lot sharper. A capture card will also record your camera audio, which can save some headache because you don't have to adjust for latency. On the other hand, the software is free and still in beta, so what can we expect? I personally think that the Lumix Tether for streaming software should be enough for everyone that intends to use it as a webcam for chatting. Yes, you need to use some workarounds, but if Panasonic follows the same path as Canon, setting everything up should be a lot easier in a future version. I honestly feel so grateful because Panasonic listened. This is generally a good sign and something not every company does. I also hope that this mindset will transfer to their Lumix product line, especially the upcoming GH6, which could indeed be the perfect camera. If they fix the few issues the GH5 had and consider customer wishes in the development of their future products, like they did with this software right here, an exciting future lies ahead. I really hope this video was helpful for you, and if you still have any further questions, then please let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you're excited about new upcoming videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.